customers love the Enchirito because it's a different item. It's big, it's filling, it's spicy.
Operationally, for us, the Enchirito is a big win. All our ingredients are currently in the store, and it's an easy product to train and to roll out to the crews.
I just tried the Enchirito, and it's definitely my new Taco Bell favorite.
I think they love it because of the taste. It's a unique taste. It's like nothing else you can get in any of the quick service restaurants in town. Lots of sauce, lots of cheese, great taste. Customers just love it.
Thanks, Bill. I love the Enchirito. It's hot, it's flavorful, and it's a terrific product. And it's a great way for us to start the year 2000, what we're calling the year of the food at Taco Bell. And I know as I visit restaurants and I talk to restaurant general managers, assistant managers, and team members, one common theme is clear. We all love our food at Taco Bell. In fact, we're food fanatics. And we're so proud of our food, we're going to guarantee our food to our customers. You'll love it or your money back. And great food every day for every visit with our customers is what our business is all about. You take that and you combine it with consistent champ service and you've got a great business proposition. And it all starts with our leadership. So good luck with the Enchirito and the beginning of the year of the food at Taco Bell.
Enchirito that we're introducing in Module 1 is made with seasoned beef, chicken, or steak, plus beans and onions all rolled up in a flour tortilla. Then it's smothered with sauce and topped with cheddar cheese. The new Enchirito is available in two different sauce options. Our guests can order it with red chili sauce or our green tomatillo sauce. The beef Enchirito with red chili or green tomatillo sauce is priced at just 99 cents for Module 1. There will also be an Enchirito combo that includes one Enchirito, two crunchy tacos, and a large drink. Let's get started. The first thing we always do is to wash and sanitize our hands. Every great tasting Enchirito begins with a fresh, hot, 6.5-inch heat-pressed tortilla. High-quality heat-pressed tortillas are the foundation of the Enchirito that our guests like during market tests. Tortilla quality is the first critical step towards delivering great Enchiritos. So make sure your team reviews key preparation and holding procedures. Let's review the procedures for preparing green tomatillo sauce. Tomatillo sauce is a green, mildly spicy sauce with a tangy flavor that is made with tomatillos, which are sometimes called Mexican green tomatoes. For those of you not currently familiar with green tomatillo sauce, you will find that this is a very easy ingredient to prepare. When receiving green tomatillo sauce, always verify that there are at least 2 months remaining before the expiration date. If not, contact the QA help desk. You may store green tomatillo sauce in either dry storage or the walk-in. To determine the amount of green tomatillo sauce to prepare, use the prep guide. To prepare the sauce, place the bags in the rethermalizer for 30 minutes. Verify that the product has reached 165 degrees. Remove and place in a clean, sanitized 6-inch 1/6 pan. Cover the pan with a hinged lid. Label the holding time, 4 hours, and place it on the line. While on the line, stir the green tomatillo sauce every 10 minutes and keep the lid closed when not in use. If your restaurant is currently serving quesadillas, you should use your half-ounce ladles for portioning green tomatillo sauce. Place 3 ladles full of green tomatillo sauce on top of the Enchirito with your half-ounce ladle. This equals 2 ounces by weight. Now we'll show you how to prepare this menu item on the line. To begin, the steamer will place a flour tortilla in his or her palm and portion 1 1/2 ounce of beans and 1 1/2 ounce of protein, beef, chicken, or steak, lengthwise down the center of the tortilla. Then portion 1/4 ounce of white onions onto the beans and meat. Remember, we want a taste of every ingredient in every bite. Next, one side of the tortilla is folded over to cover the beans and meat, about 3/4 of the way up. Loosely, roll the Enchirito over so that the flaps are underneath the product. Let's see that one more time. Loosely, roll the enchirito over so that the flaps are underneath the product. Place the enchirito diagonally in a nacho supreme tray. Laying it diagonally in the tray minimizes the amount of tortilla that hangs over the tray edges. Using your 1 ounce ladle, portion 2 ounces of red chili sauce or green tomatillo sauce on the enchirito, spreading it evenly over the entire rolled tortilla. Now place the enchirito on the taco rail. The steamer must communicate what type of enchirito has just been prepared. Is it beef, chicken, or steak? This will improve order accuracy and speed of service. The stuffer portions 1 ounce of cheddar cheese down the entire length of the enchirito. Now place the enchirito on a paddle and carefully place it into the melter for one cycle. Melting the enchirito is the key to delivering the melted cheese that our guests have told us they want. When the melting cycle is complete, carefully remove the paddle from the cheese melter to avoid any sauce from spilling. Pass the melted enchirito to the wrapper expediter. Be sure to communicate which enchirito you're handing down to the expediter.
This is chicken.
Is it beef, chicken, or steak? Dine-in orders should be placed on a tray and served to the guest. For takeout orders, place the enchirito into the Nachos Supreme clamshell. Use the special tab to identify the enchirito. Use chicken and steak stickers when necessary. To avoid any sauce spilling, ensure that the clamshell is closed properly. Verify that the tops on each corner are securely closed. Place no more than 2 enchiritos into a medium bag or 4 into a large bag. When placing the enchiritos into the plastic bag, be sure to keep them horizontal to prevent sauce from spilling. Include a spork with every enchirito ordered. Here are 5 best practices to help you hit the A, P, and S in Champs. A best practice for accuracy is to place dine-in chicken and steak enchiritos into a clamshell and use the appropriate sticker for proper identification. To ensure correct product portioning, use the green-handled number 12 disher for accurate cheddar cheese portioning. Finally, to improve speed of service, have steamers make enchiritos first. That way, while enchiritos are melting, the steamer and stuffer can finish the rest of the order. Also, 2 enchiritos may be placed on each paddle to improve efficiency. Place the onions as close to the steam station as possible to minimize the steamer's movement down the line. Now it's your turn to make an enchirito. Your manager will demonstrate for you how to make the perfect enchirito. Every team member should make 1 beef enchirito with red chili sauce and 1 chicken enchirito with green tomatillo sauce. After everyone has had a chance to make their enchiritos, return to the dining room and resume viewing the video. Now, stop the videotape to continue the training process.